We're going to look at what is slope today. The word slope is also somewhat interchangeable with the concept of rate of change, but rate of change is associated more with a curve, and slope is associated more with a line. So let's look at the slopes of these lines in the graphs right here. Okay, all three of these on this first graph have what we call a positive slope. Why? Because as you move from left to right, just like when you read, your slope is increasing. So you always go left to right, and these are all increasing. So let's actually count our slope. Our slope is our rise over our run. So I'm going to count from point to point. I'm going to count the rise and go up 1, 2, 3 over 2. So the slope of this line is a positive 3 over 2 because it's the rise over the run. Okay, let's look at the second example here. This one, we're going to rise 1 unit and we're going to go over 1, 2, 3, 4 units. So the rise is 1 and the run is 4. So that would be 1/4 slope. Now let's look at in terms of a curve. Now the curve, we really don't call this slope, but we call it the rate of change. But you do this exact same thing. You look at 2 points, look at that interval, and you're going up 1, 2, 3, and over 2. So this has a slope or an average rate of change of 2/3 from 0 to +2. So that's how you count rate of change. Now let's look at a few examples of negative slopes. Okay, again, we're looking at the negative slope. We're looking from left to right, and we're going to count our rise over our run again. But again, we're going left to right, and notice these are all sloping downward. Okay, so let's go through a couple of these. We've got a rise of 1, 2 over 1, 2, 3, 4. So this one is a rise of 2, a run of 4, but it's also going down, so we make that slope negative. Now this one reduces, so it's going to reduce by 2, so I'm going to get -1/2 as the slope of this line. Okay, let's count this one. This one, we've got 2 points right here, so it's just down 1 and over 1. So 1 over 1 is 1, but remember, it's going down, so we make those -1. Okay, here's one down here. We're going down 1, 2, 3, 4 over 1. So 4 over 1, which is the whole number, -4. So this slide is a little steeper, and it's got a larger absolute value of a negative number. And then here's a curve, and a curve is counted the same way. We look at the 2 points, the interval from what, 1, 2, 3, 4, from where x is 4 to where x is 6, the interval of the slope or the rate of change would be 1, 2, 3 over 2. So down 3 and over 2. And that's how you find slope.